came in today to let you know Jesus Christ saves, and Jesus Christ heals, and Jesus Christ delivers. We came in today to let you know that the gift of God is in your life. The gift of God is a free gift, and you can receive eternal life today in Christ Jesus. And when you come to Jesus today, you can receive eternal life. You can be part of the kingdom of God. We're calling this city to the kingdom of God. And this is the greatest hour to be part of the kingdom of God. Not enough? The time is now to know Jesus Christ. If you don't know about Jesus Christ, we are here. You can come and ask any questions. If you need prayers, we are here. We're going to believe God will heal you today, because we believe in the power of the Holy Spirit. We believe in God. And we understand what God has done in our lives. Praise the Lord. I'm lifting up the name of Jesus Christ. I'm lifting up the name of my Savior. He's my Lord and King. He's I am that I am. I'm lifting up the name of Jesus Christ. Wherever I go, I want to let you know that Jesus Christ is alive. Not a man do you know, Jesus is alive. Jesus is alive. That's why we came. I know I can't sing. I didn't sing for you. I just came to sing for God. That's the difference. You see, when you worship God, it doesn't matter how it sounds like, but it comes from the inside. Hallelujah. He gives me hope, yeah. He gives me joy. He gives me love. He's all I need. Jesus Christ is alive. Jesus Christ is my everything. He gives me hope, yeah. He gives me joy. He gives me love. He's my everything. Jesus Christ is alive. Jesus Christ is my everything. He gives me hope, yeah. He gives me joy. He gives me love. He's my everything. We believe in Jesus. We believe in Jesus. We believe in Jesus. He's coming back again. We believe in Jesus. We believe in Jesus. He came to save. He came to save. Whoa. Not enough. Do you know? Jesus Christ. Makes the broken hearted. He restores sight. Jesus Christ is alive. Jesus Christ is our everything. He's greater than money, yeah. He's greater than fame. Jesus Christ. He's on everything. That's right. We believe in Jesus. We believe in Jesus. We believe in Jesus. He's on everything. He gives us hope, yeah. He gives us love, yeah. He gives us joy. He's on everything. Not enough. We got somebody. And that person is Jesus Christ. We've got the Savior of the world. Oh my God. And He came to save us. He came to change our lives. That's why we speak about Jesus Christ. We get excited about the name of Jesus, because there's hope in that name, Jesus. Jesus Christ came to save us. Jesus Christ came to rescue us. Jesus Christ came from our sins. Jesus Christ changed us from the inside out.
That's why we speak about Jesus Christ. We speak about Jesus Christ with passion. We speak about Jesus Christ because we know who Jesus is. You see, some people say that Jesus Christ is a prophet. Some people say he's a good man. Some people say he's a rabbi. But we say Jesus Christ is God in the flesh. We say Jesus Christ is the Savior of the world, the soul's coming King. We say God is alive. And we came to Nottingham to let you know, come alive in God. You see, Jesus Christ came to give us life in God. Jesus Christ came to give us life and more abundantly. Because the devil comes to kill and destroy. But Jesus Christ came to give us life. Oh my God, when you come to Jesus Christ, you be a fire for God. When you come to Jesus Christ, there is no hate in God. There is no evil in God. There is peace in God. There is love in God. There's forgiveness of sin in God. Let me tell you something. There's no condemnation to them that in Christ Jesus. You're not condemned when in Christ Jesus. My God, there is a reason. There is a reason why Jesus came. There's a reason why Jesus Christ came. Jesus Christ came as the Savior of the world, and he died on the cross. He paid a punishment for sin. Jesus Christ was beaten all day long. Jesus Christ was beaten. He was mocked. He was slapped. He was bruised. He was placed on the side for me and you. He took upon him the punishment of sin. He took upon him the sins of the world. My God, if we say we don't sin, we are lying to ourselves, but we sin before God. And as a result of our sin before God, there had to be a worthy sacrifice to deal with sin. Sin was dealt on the cross. Sin was dealt on the cross. It was the cross. It was the saving cross. It was the blood that was shed on the cross. The blood of Jesus Christ. We speak about the blood of Jesus. Because it's in the blood of Jesus Christ. That is where. The blood of Jesus. There is power in the blood of Jesus. It is able to transform your life. There is power in the blood of Jesus. Jesus Christ shed blood on the cross. He paid a punishment for sin on earth. He died in our place. You see, there was no sin found in Jesus. They call him a prophet. They say Jesus Christ is a prophet. But let me tell you something about a prophet. A prophet is a person just like me and you. Some people say he's a prophet, but a prophet can sin. There was no sin found in Jesus Christ. That is why we know they're telling a lie. Let me tell you something. And the truth is found in Jesus. There's no truth found in religion. And let me tell you something, my love. We didn't come here for religion. We came here for Jesus. And I made that clear. We didn't come here for religion. But we came because of Jesus. You see, Jesus Christ never came to introduce religion. Jesus Christ never came to introduce religion to humanity. But Jesus Christ said this. He said, repent. He said, repent, not at all. For the kingdom of God is at hand. There is a difference when you know the kingdom of God. There's a difference when you know the kingdom. Jesus Christ came to introduce his kingdom, not religion. That is why we don't speak about religion, but we speak about a relationship with Jesus Christ. Because as I'm speaking to you, Jesus Christ is speaking to you. And that's an awesome thing when you have a relationship like that with Jesus Christ. That is why I know something, not enough, that Jesus Christ is alive. We don't just speak about Jesus Christ because we're so excited. No. We speak about Jesus Christ because we have a relationship with him. He fills our heart with his awesome love. Woo! My God is alive. Woo-hoo! Let me tell you something. Oh my God, that's why we said it's not a real. You see, we don't hate. No. My Jesus, my people, hold me this. He says, love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your mind, and everything that's within you. Love your neighbor as yourself. There's no killing in Christianity. Can I make that clear? There's no killing, there's no evil in Christianity. Because Christianity comes from Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ never went on anybody, but Jesus Christ died on the cross. He paid the punishment for sin. When you look at the cross, my God, have you ever seen Jesus' hand on the cross? You can't even look at it. That's how your sin was on the cross. He died for the sins of the world. He was beaten. He was spat. He was not even recognized. Because he took upon him the punishment for sin. And wherever Jesus Christ went, he forgave sin. Because your sin, can you search your heart? Can you really search in your heart and say you don't sin? Man's problem is not the government. Man's problem is sin. Because when sin is dealt with, everything else is guaranteed. My God, because there's a guarantee in Jesus Christ. There's no guarantee on your head. My God. There's never been a guarantee in religion. Religion has caused so many problems in this world. But there's a solution. There's a solution in Jesus. My God, there's an answer in Jesus Christ. Jesus said, look to me. Jesus Christ said, look to me. He didn't say, look to religion. God bless you. He didn't say, look to religion. He didn't say, look to a prophet. He didn't say, look to the government. He said, look to me. Jesus said, look to me. Jesus is calling. My God, we're not calling you to ourselves, but we're calling you to the masters. We're calling you to the King of Glory. We're calling you to Jesus Christ, because that's the difference when you know Jesus. Even when they put the gun to your head, you still have to deny Jesus, because that's the difference. You see, in the Middle East, if you go to the Middle East, they kill Christians. They chop off their head. And even in Africa, Christians are burned alive. Oh, did you know, my God, can I expose the people a little bit? Let me tell you something. Even what you're doing right now, in Africa, some people, they get burned alive for becoming a Christian. Some people, they get their hands chopped off. They get their hands chopped off for standing for God. But let me tell you something. The time is coming, not enough, where the power of God will begin to convict the lives of people like never before. And everybody, every religion will know Jesus Christ, the truth shall be exposed like never before. And the truth is coming into the mainstream, because they're not the real thing. Because where there's a counterfeit, there must be a genuine. Where there is a false, there must be truth. Where there's good, there must be bad. Where's the devil, there must be Jesus Christ. And we know Jesus. That's why we speak about him. That's why we don't shake when people mock us.
Because if you confess the Lord Jesus Christ, oh my God,
When I gave my life to Jesus in the year 2001, let me tell you something. It took 7 years. It took 7 years before I heard the voice of Jesus. That is why I know one thing. But Jesus Christ speaks. I'm speaking to you. He can speak to your soul. He can speak to your life. What this nation needs is an encounter with Jesus. What this nation needs is a visitation with Jesus Christ. Like William Booth, a man of God that was in the city. Like my God, we need true conviction, because when there's true conviction on the street, everybody will know Jesus Christ, because it's better to know Jesus than to believe in a lie. That's why we don't speak about religion, because religion is a lie, and I made that clear. Mando Rabba Sokona, can I speak about the truth? My Jesus does not lie. There's no sin found in Jesus. Do your research. Am I telling lies? Even if they say the prophet, there's no lies found in Jesus. Jesus said, I am the way. Jesus said, I am the truth. Jesus said, I am the life. No one comes to the Father except for me. So therefore, even if you say he's a prophet, why are you not following Jesus Christ, but you're following somebody else? If they call Jesus Christ a prophet, why are they believing in something else? Can I expose this stuff? Because the truth shall set you free. And when the truth came into my life, it set me free. It broke the chains of addiction. It changed my circumstance. When I came to Jesus, I became a powerful God. And I came there without compromise. To let somebody know that my Jesus is the way, my Jesus is the truth, and my Jesus is the Lord. It is the love of Jesus Christ. That's why we're here today. If we did not love one another, if we did not love one another, we would still go about our jobs. We will still do it if we do anything else. If we do not love share, if we do not love, if we do not have a relationship with God, we won't tell you the truth. But the truth comes to set you free. And when the truth comes, you begin to explain your soul to it. Not really right now. When you begin to understand the truth, you become alive. Oh, you see, there's so many broken hearts in Nottingham. Every time when I walk through the street, I see so much depression. I see so much people in depression and stress. But let me tell you something. Come to Jesus and let Jesus fill the emptiness that you've put inside. Let me tell you something. Jesus Christ can fix your heart. Jesus Christ can fix your home. Let me tell you something. I used to be a homeless person. I used to be tossed outside around 5 a.m. in the morning. But let me tell you something. I used to be jobless. I was depressed. I was suicidal. I did not have no hope. But one thing I did, I said, Jesus rescued me. I said, Jesus saved me. And let me tell you something. Jesus Christ came and he saved my life. That is why I speak about Jesus the way I do. And nobody can stop me. Because why? I have the Spirit of God. They tried to stop me. The police tried to stop me. But let me tell you something. There's a greater force, and that is the Holy Ghost. There's a greater power, and that is the Holy Ghost and fire. And when you become a fire for God, you change the ship from inside out. There's no evil in Jesus, but there's joy in Jesus. There's love in Jesus Christ. Let Jesus save you today. Let Jesus Christ touch your heart. Let Jesus Christ do something inside. That name Jesus, that is whom we believe. We believe in Jesus, and we'll shout it out. We'll shout it out in this city that Jesus Christ is the only way. Jesus Christ is the only truth. And Jesus Christ is the only life. He's the only way to the kingdom of God. The kingdom of God. You don't want to be in the kingdom of darkness, but you want to be in the kingdom of heaven. Because there's a better kingdom. There's a better kingdom. There's a better kingdom, and that is heaven. I surely want to get to heaven. I surely want to become of the kingdom of God. Mando Rabba Sokona. And the kingdom of God is only here. The one person. And that is Jesus. That name Jesus. Let it be known unto them. It is Jesus Christ. Let it be known unto them. It is the name of Jesus. Not religion. Not the government. Don't you know we are greater than the God? Don't you know God created us? Don't you know that God gave us identity? And this identity, when you begin to understand identity in Christ Jesus, there is a difference when you know Jesus Christ. Somebody has to know the truth in this end time. I might not be the most intelligent person, but one thing I know Jesus, and nobody else can change my mind because Jesus spoke to me. When Jesus speaks to you, that's the difference. Because when Jesus speaks, you'll be able to understand the voice of the devil and the voice of Jesus Christ. And Jesus Christ is still speaking today. Jesus Christ is still saving lives today. Jesus Christ is still healing the sick. Let me tell you something. I've seen a blind person seen again. I've seen people that have cancer being held by the power of God. I've seen people that are addicted to crack being held by the name of Jesus. I've seen alcoholics being saved by the name of Jesus. If there's nothing real about the name of Jesus, nothing will happen. Seriously, if there's nothing real about Jesus, nothing will happen. That's why we don't speak out of wisdom or intelligence. We speak from truth. We speak out of experience. We speak about experience because experience is the best teacher. When you put your hands in hot water, it is painful, right? If you put your hands in hot water, you experience that it's painful. The same way we have experienced Jesus Christ. The same way we have encountered Jesus Christ. That is why we came out today to let somebody know that when you come to Jesus Christ, you are saved from eternity. It may sound like foolishness, but it's a serious matter. It's a serious matter, not enough, to understand who Jesus is and what Jesus has done for humanity. This is the time to be saved in Jesus Christ. This is the time to know Jesus. Not religion, but Jesus Christ. God bless you, everyone.